You are now entering the Nintendo Power Zone. Now you're podcasting with power.
PowerZone, guys, it's your boy, Max193, with a brand new breakdown, and this is a breakdown I am so excited to talk about. It's all about Super Nintendo World. So late last night, Nintendo and Universal Studios Japan released a trailer for Super Nintendo World that shows off a great deal of what the park should look like. Now, granted, the commercial is done using rendered CGI, but I would venture to guess this is very much what the park will look like once it's completed. So the trailer starts with Mario entering a warp pipe, and I would guess that this is also how the visitors of the park will enter as well. And if that's actually the case, right off the bat, the park guests will immediately feel immersed in Super Nintendo World. Once Mario passes through the pipe, he is immediately inside of the Super Nintendo World section of Universal Japan, and this looks very much like the concept art that was revealed to us last December. In fact, as far as I can tell, not much of anything has really changed in this design concept at all. Once Mario is inside the park, the first thing we notice is Peach's castle standing directly behind him, and it's beautiful. Let the Disney parks have their Cinderella and Sleeping Beauty castles, because Peach's castle is every bit, if not more, stunning. And if these renders are accurate, this castle is going to be both quite large and spectacular. I mean, just go ahead and look at the stained glass window that adorns the front of Peach's castle. I love the colors on that. It looks amazing. Next, the camera pans out to reveal the majority of the park. We see an awesome layered mountain off in the distance on the right hand side, and at the peak of the mountain is the flagpole that Mario reaches at the end of most stages. To the left of that is Bowser's castle, and it is so amazingly detailed and dark looking. It's a nice juxtaposition to Peach's bright and stunning castle, and I love how Bowser's face with an open mouth is used as an entry point to the castle. I'm guessing this castle will house one of the ride attractions, which I can't say for certain as Nintendo has really played their cards close to the chest as to what rides we're going to see, with the exception of one, but we're going to go ahead and we'll talk about that a little bit later. Back to Bowser's castle, I am noticing that this Bowser castle is very similar to the one used in recent Mario Kart games. To the left of Bowser's castle, we see more mountainside along with a piranha plant off in the distance. Also, look at the floor Mario is standing on. It's a super mushroom done in tiles, and it looks fantastic. Finally, Mario is greeted by park guests as he rushes off to the next scene. Next up, we are directly in front of Bowser's castle, and look at all the minor details we couldn't really see when it was in the distance. You see flags and banners all depicting Bowser's silhouetted image. The entry point, which looks like Bowser's face, is covered in rivets and has yellow glowing eyes. The towers at the side of the castle are spiked and covered in rivets as well, and I love this kind of detail. This is what really sets it apart from any castle we've ever seen in a theme park. And lastly, we have two piranha plants stationed at either side of Bowser's mouth. In this trailer, they snap at Mario. I wonder if when the park is complete, whether or not these will merely be prop replicas of the piranha plants, or whether or not they will be animatronic in some way. Personally, I'm hoping for the latter, because it would be awesome if the piranha plants moved and snapped at you. In the next scene, we see Mario scaling the mountain. This is the only part of the trailer that kind of bums me out due to the fact that I'm certain that this is only for show and guests won't really have any access to this mountain for safety purposes. But what really looks cool here is the aesthetics of it all. There are coins, and even though Mario touches them, they don't disappear, which makes me think that these are permanent fixtures to the mountain, and we're going to talk about this more a little later. We also see a question mark block here as well, and there is so much attention to detail that I'm certain I'm already missing a lot of details just in this scene alone. Once Mario reaches the top of the mountain, he grabs the flagpole and the camera zooms out to reveal the park from an angle we have not yet seen up to this point. And it is stunning, okay? Look at the scope of this section of the park. It's massive. We can see so many more details looking at the park from this angle. Immediately though, my eyes are drawn to the red toad house. Taking a stab, I'm guessing that this would be some sort of standalone gift shop or restaurant. In the center of the park, there's a piranha plant and a Goomba sitting in a grass section of the park. And right beside Bowser's castle to the left, there's an ice stage and so much more. I cannot believe all the little details that this park has, and it's so vibrant and full of color. This truly does look like a Mario game brought to life. Finally, the trailer ends with the Super Nintendo World logo. Okay, so now I want to go ahead and go back to the trailer that was released last November, because now that we've seen this concept trailer for the park, there are a lot of details from that announcement trailer that we can place in the new trailer. So once Mark Woodbury begins speaking in this trailer, directly behind him, we see a Koopa Troopa shell and a red spiny shell. We also see a question mark block and a super mushroom. I'm guessing that this setting will most likely be within Bowser's castle, based on the greater wall that's right behind the super mushroom. Longtime Mario fans should recognize the greater wall from the Bowser Castle stages of Super Mario World. They were used to climb in those games, but I don't think the staff at Universal will be encouraging people to climb these. When the camera angle shifts, we also see Fire Flower and Super Star props. It's interesting that the Fire Flower is illuminated and the star isn't, but they don't really fit into what I was saying earlier about these props being used for Bowser's Castle, as there's nothing in the background that would indicate that to me. When Miyamoto begins speaking, he is clearly in the ice section that I mentioned that was directly next to Bowser's castle. We also see a spinning coin behind him to the left. I believe that this coin will be one of the permanent fixtures that we saw on the mountainside. There's something else that's pretty cool here. We get to see the music note blocks from Super Mario Bros. 3, and it's apparently in the ice section as well. And that's really all I can tell from this trailer that's going to add to the trailer that we just watched, but it's cool to see what some of the props will look like in comparison to the CGI renders. And finally, we have the groundbreaking ceremony, which just looks like a lot of fun. And even here, we are treated to some amazing details. We have warp pipes, brick blocks, coin props, Goomba props, and even Koopa Troopa shell props, all done in a life-size scale. And all this just looks amazing. It is during this groundbreaking ceremony that they announced that we are, in fact, getting a Mario Kart experience that will use state-of-the-art technology to create an immersive and fun experience. They also said there would be retail shops and restaurants that are exclusive to this section of the park. They said Universal will also spend about 60 billion yen on developing the park, which is roughly 544 million US dollars. What's great about this groundbreaking ceremony is that it's mostly in English, which is great for us Westerners. It even had an appearance from Miyamoto, who has worked hand in hand with Universal Studios to help create this multi-level, immersive Super Nintendo World. But guys, that's about all the details that I could find that were given about Super Nintendo World today. I hope you guys found this breakdown enjoyable. It was definitely one of my most ambitious breakdowns. I never thought I'd be breaking down a theme park trailer, but I am so excited about this, and I have to find a way to be there for the grand opening of this park. Anyway guys, it's time for me to go ahead and get out of your hair, but before I do, gotta hit you up with these social media links. You can hit me up on Twitter at nice1983 or at npowerzone. You can email me at nice1983@gmail.com. You can hit me up on Facebook, facebook.com/nintendopowerzone. If you're a fan of the Nintendo PowerZone podcast, you can always download new episodes on iTunes, Google Play Music, and stream new episodes on Stitcher Radio. If you're a fan of the Nintendo PowerZone podcast and you like watching us live, though, you can watch us right here on YouTube, youtube.com/user/thearticle, thearticle. And guys, we don't just do the podcast here. We have breakdown videos and we have unboxing videos. So guys, thank you guys so much for watching. If you like the video, please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. Deuces.